Hello everyone, my name is Mansi Anand and I'm going to be taking your marketing lecture. In this lecture, we'll study about marketing segmentation. So if you like this video, do hit the subscribe button and you can also join our Telegram group for the latest updates. So let's begin with it. So segmentation, what do you mean by segmentation? So segmentation, the name in itself tells us dividing something into various segments. So in terms of marketing, segmentation means dividing the market or your targeted audience into well-defined slices. So let us take the example of a school. In a school, there are about 5,000 to 10,000 students. Those 10,000 students, all of them are there to get education, right? But still they are divided into various number of classes. So why is it so? Students are divided into various classes ranging from nursery to class 12. This is because students of different age have different needs. They require teachers to take different steps according to their age and according to their mental capability to make them understand different concepts. Similarly, in the context of marketing, when we talk about segmentation, it means that the marketer wants to divide audience into different segments and then know about them distinctively and then trying to fulfill their needs. So a market segment consists of a group of customers who share similar set of needs and wants. So in the example of the school, if we talk about different students, so let's say there are two students, one belonging to class 5 and one belonging to class 7. So both of them must be having different needs or different requirements by a teacher. That is why they belong to different classes. But students of class 5 must be having similar needs. That is why they are into one class. Similarly, students of class 7 also must be having similar needs. That is why they are into one class. So just as students are divided into segments, a marketer divides the target audience into various segments so that it becomes easier to cater to their needs. A market segment consists of a group of customers who share similar set of needs and wants. And marketer's task is to identify appropriate number and nature of market segments and then decide which one or ones to target. So when the marketer has divided the audience into various segments, the marketer is not going to cater to all of them. It is practically not feasible to cater to all of them, even if the marketer wants a large audience. So the marketer will have to do a cost-benefit analysis of each segment and then decide which one of them or which ones of them are worth of targeting. Now, moving on to different parameters of segmentation. So first is geographic segmentation. So under geographic segmentation comes region, city, rural and semi-urban area. So we are going to study each parameters in its detail. But first we'll just look at all of them collectively. Next is demographic segmentation. Under this, various parameters are age, family size, gender, income, occupation, education, socioeconomic classification. After that, there is psychographic segmentation. Under this, target audience is divided on the basis of lifestyle and personality they hold. The last one is behavioral segmentation, which categorizes target audience according to their behavior, and behavior is interpreted on the basis of following parameters like occasions, benefits, user status, usage rate, loyalty status, readiness stage, attitude towards the product. So let's move further to study each one of them in detail. Now, moving on to first one, that is geographic segmentation. So as you can get from its name, that this segmentation divides target audience on the basis of geographical areas, the different geographical areas, the different locations they reside in or they belong to. So the place where a consumer or a person lives affects the way they think, their thought processes. So all these geographical factors affect a consumer's thought process. That is why it is very important for the marketer to understand that from which place does the customer or the consumer belong to, and how can they be catered, and how can they be persuaded to pull them towards the product or service that the marketer is offering. So under geographic segmentation, consumers are divided on the basis of nations, different countries they belong to. Consumers in US must be having really different needs than consumers in India. So states they belong to. So consumers in different states, regions, countries, cities, or neighborhoods. So basically different locations that a consumer is residing in. So geographical markets vary in their product preferences and requirements. So there are various factors like culture, climate, which affects people living in different geographical areas and their preferences towards different products and services. So if a marketer or a company is aware about the different geographical places from where the consumer is belonging, it becomes really easy for the company to tailor their marketing programs according to the needs and wants of the local customer groups in different trading areas, neighborhoods, and even individual stores. So let's say if there is an MNC in the textile business and having stores at a very hot place and a very cold place. So the company would have to decide accordingly that at what clothes it wants to sell in the hot area and what clothes it wants to sell in the cold area. So that is why if the company or the marketer is aware about the geographical location of the consumer, it can easily cater to their needs and tailor their marketing programs according to the needs and wants of local consumers. So let's see some examples which would help us to understand this concept a little better. So examples of geographic segmentation. So there are many courier companies in many cities which specialize in delivering mails and packets on the same day at different places, but in a particular specified geographical area within the city. So as we discussed the example of hot and cool place, so we can relate this example with that example. So in arid regions of South Asian countries, during the hot and dry summer season, so South Asian countries, they usually see a hot and dry summer season. So air coolers are really ineffective there, which can be easily used in coastal areas. So air coolers are ineffective in arid regions, but they are effective in coastal areas where the climate is hot but humid. In southern states of India like Tamil Nadu, coffee is preferred over tea, which is a hot preference in northern states of India. So in some parts of India, consumers have a distinct preference for strong tea, which usually comes from Assam region. And in some parts of India, there is preference for, Darjeeling or Nilgiri tea. So many banks in India have specialized branches to cater to the needs of various groups of customers. So in smaller regions of India, banks usually prefer to perform relationship banking, where banks have relationship executives who can better attend to the needs of local customers in a more customized way. So if banks are having an executive who is aware of needs of local customers, so the local customer would be really comfortable to do banking with that executive rather than an executive who does not understand the needs and wants of that consumer. So it is very important to have executives belonging to the local area where the bank branches is operating, so that customers can be catered in a more customized way. So brands like Asharwad and MTR, they assess the taste and flavor preferences for the food items in different parts of India and then promote those products accordingly. So in southern states, you can see there is more preference for dishes like dosa and upma, which are not so popular in northern part of the country. Now moving on to next segmentation parameter, that is demographic segmentation. So here also we can assess it from its name that this segmentation divides target audience on the basis of demographics. Demographics means different characteristics of human population, that what is the age of consumer, what family size is he or she belonging to, the religion practiced by consumer, the race he or she is belonging to, the generation, the age gap, the nationality, the family life cycle, gender of the consumer. So all these things tells us facts about the population. And that is why demographic segmentation is really easy to measure in its financial sense. Now let's move on to some examples of demographic segmentation which would help us to better understand this concept. So television channels. Television channels are categorized according to the different preferences of consumer. So channels like Disney, Jetix, Hangama, Pogo, they are usually targeted at children, showing content what would relate to them. And channels like Aastha and Sanskar are usually targeted at spiritually inclined older audience. So channels like Discovery and National Geographic, which are more informative, they are targeted towards people interested in education. Titan, a renowned watch brand, they prepared watches for children with their new brand called Zoop. So one thing to notice here is when Titan brought a brand for children, they tried to name it in such a way that would attract, that would be relatable to children who are their target customers in the case of this brand. So next, Eyeball, launching Eyeball Asan. So it is basically a phone specifically targeted at older audiences. So in all these examples, we can say that demographic segmentation is being done on the basis of age of consumer. Brands like Van Heusen and Allen Solly, which used to be men's clothing brands, they entered women's market by providing clothes for women. So Emami, it is basically a cosmetic brand producing hygiene products and cosmetic products. So it traditionally focused on women, but as the trend for male beauty products is increasing nowadays, it also launched a special cream called Fair and Handsome for men. So this is basically a fairness cream for men. We do not advertise fairness creams here. So we can usually see motorcycles advertisements as being branded as really masculine, whereas advertisements for scooties are usually advertised as a family vehicle or as a vehicle which is easily driven by men as well as women of the house. TVS scooties or Honda Activa's advertisements are really different from that of motorcycles. So you won't see Activa's and Royal Enfield's advertisement in similar taste. They are going to be really different, poles apart. These examples, they cater to segmentation on the basis of gender. A concept called sachet marketing, which involves providing products in little packets to rural customers. So basically here in this case, the segmentation is being done on the basis of rural and urban customers. So rural customers who are not very rich or who belong to the lower section of society, for them products are being packaged in smaller sachets, which would make easier for those customers to buy these little packages of products. Rather than buying a whole bottle of shampoo, a customer belonging to rural area would be more comfortable in buying a packet of shampoo. Rolex, Omega and all these watches brand cater to high profile customers. So Arvind Eye Care System, this example was also discussed in our earlier lecture. So Arvind Eye Care System, it provides medical treatment to cataract patients. So it provides world class eye care treatment to poor people. So in these examples, the segmentation is being done on the economic background of the consumer or the income levels of the consumer. So moving on to the next one. So the next one is psychographic segmentation. So in this parameter of segmentation, the target audience is divided on the basis of psychological or personality traits, lifestyle, or different values that the consumer holds. So one of the major parameter which is really important in this type of segmentation is religion, because religion has a huge impact on the thought process of the consumer. So what kind of clothes do the consumer wear, what kind of food they eat, what kinds of activities do they indulge in, all these things are affected by the religion on practices. So religion can have a significant influence on the values, attitudes and lifestyle of the consumer, and as a consequence it shapes the product and brand choices. Let us look at some of the examples. McDonald's, when it came to India, it had to change their entire menu to adapt to vegetarian consumers that they were catering to in India. So they had to change their beef burgers to make veggie burger and make aloo tikki burger, which would be more appealing to customers in India who prefer vegetarian food. So next example is of halal meat. So halal meat is the meat which is permissible according to Islamic law. So people practicing Muslim religion, they can consume only halal meat. So that is why with the meat which is imported to Islamic countries like Pakistan and Bangladesh from other countries has to be certified that it belongs to this category by certain Islamic organizations. So many restaurants in South Asia also serve both type of meats to cater to both type of customers, Muslims and non-Muslim guests. So moving on to the next one, High Design. High Design is a high-end brand which manufactures and markets high-end leather accessories and is usually targeted at people who value style and elegance in a classic sense. So it is a high-end brand catering to the needs of people who are usually really conscious about their style statement. These type of brands help the consumer to make a personal statement about themselves. So Titan, we discussed Titan in earlier example also. They also have a wide range of sub brands ranging from Edge, Regalia, Nebula, Raga to appeal to different customer segments, to appeal to people belonging to different lifestyles so that they can fulfill the needs of different types of consumers. So under psychographic segmentation, when we are studying about the values, attitudes and lifestyles of people, so there is a model which would be really helpful to us to understand psychographic segmentation on a better level. This is Strategic Business Insights Values, Attitude and Lifestyle Framework. So basically this is more like a research project in US which classifies US customers into 8 different categories on the basis of resources they own and on the basis of principles which motivate such consumers. So I'm going to show you a diagram, and in that diagram the vertical dimension, it represents the degree to which consumers are innovative and have resources, and the horizontal dimension, it represents primary motivations of the consumers, and it includes 3 distinct types, that is ideals, achievement and self-expression. So let me show you the diagram first. So here you can see the diagram of values, attitudes and lifestyle framework. So on vertical axis it is measuring the degree to which the consumer is innovative and possesses the resources, and on the horizontal axis it is measuring the motivations of different consumers. So it comprises of 3 different types, that is ideals, achievement and self-expression. So this framework tells us that those consumers who are motivated by ideals, they are categorized into 2 parts, thinkers and believers. So they are guided by knowledge and principles. And those consumers who are motivated by achievement, they are categorized into achievers and strivers. So they are into products and services which would demonstrate their success to their peers. That is why they are motivated by achievement. And people who are motivated by self-expression, they desire social or physical activity, variety and risk. So personality traits such as energy, self-confidence, intellectualism, innovativeness, impulsiveness, all those traits determine an individual's resources. And different level of resources motivate different types of consumers to behave in different ways. So consumers who are really high on resources, and they can be motivated by any of the three principles, they are categorized as innovators. And customers who are really low on resources and they are usually not motivated by any of the principles, they are categorized as survivors. So let us read about all these classifications in a little bit of detail. So these are the traits of different classifications that we just studied about. So innovators, people who are really motivated and they are high on resources and they can be motivated by any of the principle. They are successful, sophisticated, and take charge people. They are really high on taking initiatives and they are full of self-esteem. So their purchases or their consumer behavior usually reflects cultivated taste for relatively upscale and niche oriented products. That is, they are not into mass produced products. They really like products and services that cater to their individual needs. Next, thinkers. Thinkers are mature, satisfied, and reflective people motivated by ideals. So since they are motivated by ideals, they value knowledge and responsibility. So they seek such products who are responsible. You cannot classify a product as responsible. So responsibility in the context of a product would mean the product being durable and fulfilling its functionality. So these people derive such traits in products. So next classification is achievers, people who are motivated by achievement. So they are obviously successful, they are goal oriented, and they like to focus on career and family, and they favor premium products. So they like high quality premium products that would reflect their success to their peers. So next category is experiencers. They are usually young and they like to indulge in different kinds of experiences. They are definitely enthusiastic. They are impulsive people who seek variety and excitement. So they usually spend a high proportion of their income on fashion, entertainment, and socializing. These are the people who like to have different kinds of experiences and invest in such products and services which will provide them with different experiences. Now coming on to categories who have lower resources. So people who have lower resources but are motivated by ideals, they are categorized as believers. So since they have low resources, they are not innovative, so they usually stick to their beliefs as they are motivated by ideals. So they are usually conservative, conventional, and traditional people with really concrete beliefs, and it is very difficult to make them try something new or make them believe in something new. Next, people having lower resources and who are motivated by achievement. So they are trendy and fun-loving people who are usually resource-constrained. So they do not have resources, but they are fun-loving. So they favor stylish products. So they favor stylish products that emulate the purchases of those with greater material wealth. So people with lower resources who are motivated by self-expression, they are known as makers. They are practical, down-to-earth, and self-sufficient people who like to work with their hands. And people who are not motivated by any of the principle and they are low on resources, they are known as survivors. They are usually elderly. So since they have no motivation, we can say that they belong to higher age groups, or they are passive people who are concerned about change, who do not like change, and they are loyal to their favorite brand. So it is very difficult to make them try something new, as they are really rigid and they are not motivated by any of the principle. So the marketer cannot motivate them easily. The last parameter of segmentation is behavioral segmentation. So in this category, division is on the basis of knowledge and attitude towards the use or response to a product of a consumer. So what knowledge does a consumer has about the product, what attitude he or she keeps about the product, or if they are aware about the uses, have they expressed any response to the product. So all these parameters are taken care of in behavioral segmentation as it dwells on the behavior of customers. So under behavioral segmentation, we see that a customer can perform various decision roles in the process of a purchase. So according to this model, people play 5 roles in a buying decision. So if a marketer is able to recognize that what kind of consumer is going to play what type of role in the buying process, it would become easier for the marketer to cater to the consumer and influence that consumer to buy his product or service. So it would become easier for the marketer to design a communication strategy if the marketer is aware about the role that the consumer is playing in the buying decision or buying process. So there is an example. Women usually play a significant role in deciding the brands of kitchen items. So that is why most of the advertisements on television, which are of consumer products and which are of products which are usually used in kitchen, they are usually catered towards women. And we can see various famous or celebrity women using those products in their own kitchens that would influence customers to buy such products. So coming on to roles played by people in buying process. So there are 5 roles. That is the initiator, the person who initiates the buying process. That is, he or she recognizes that there is a need which needs to be fulfilled and looks for different alternatives of products and services which would be able to fulfill that need. So identifies needs. Next, influencer. So this person usually influences the decision between various alternatives. Next, the decider, the person who actually makes the decision. Buyer, the person who actually makes the purchase. And the user, the person who is going to use the product at last. So let's say if there is a family and there is a grandfather and there is a father and then there is a mother and they have a daughter. Daughter recognizes that there is need for a vehicle or for a 4-wheeler in their family, which is a car. So she recognizes the need for a car and she tries to persuade her family members to buy a car. So in this case, the daughter is the initiator. The decision of the purchase would be influenced by all other family members, maybe her friends who advise her on which car to buy and which car not to buy, her family members, the decider. Let's say the grandfather, being the eldest in the family, takes all the decisions. That is why when he comes to know about the wishes of other family members, he analyzes that whether to buy a car or not. So he can be categorized as decider. Next, the buyer. So the father, who makes all the decision regarding money matters, would be the buyer who will go and actually buy the product. And user, since all of them know driving, so all of them gonna be the users. So I hope with this example, the different roles played by people in buying process are clear to you. So the last topic for this lecture is brand loyalty. How loyal a consumer is to a particular brand. So if the marketer has the information about the loyalty parameters or loyalty measures of the consumer, it can design its communication strategy in such a way that it would appeal to different consumers having different loyalty status. So under this, consumers can be categorized into 4 parts. That is hardcore loyals, split loyals, shifting loyals and switchers. So hardcore loyals are the people who get stuck to a brand. They do not shift their preferences really easily and who buy only one brand all the time. So they help to identify a product's strength. So if the marketer gains knowledge about these hardcore loyal customers, The marketer would come to know that what is the strength of my brand that these people, these consumers are sticking to my product. Knowledge about hardcore loyals would lead the marketer to knowledge about the brand's strength. Next, split loyals. So these are the people who are usually loyal to two or three brands, not one brand. They are loyal, but they are loyal to usually two or three brands. Knowledge about these type of consumers would help the marketer to identify what are the brands which are providing similar utility to the consumer as the marketer's brand, and what kind of products or what kind of services are they providing better to the consumer. That is why the consumer's preference is sticking to two or three brands and not one brand. So knowledge about these type of consumers would help the marketer to identify competition. Next are shifting loyals. So consumers who are shifting loyals, they shift from one brand to another. They help identifying company's weaknesses and correcting them. So if a marketer gains knowledge about these consumers, he or she would come to know that why are consumers shifting? There must be some reason that consumers are shifting. And once that reason is located, the marketer can work on improving those reasons and retaining the customers. So last type is switchers. So these are the people who have no loyalty towards one brand, and these type of consumers are usually not valuable and financially profitable for the company. No matter how many efforts does the company make to influence such people, but they are going to show no loyalty. So this was all about marketing segmentation. If you like this video, please do hit the subscribe button to get more updates like this.